Welcome back students. This is the second lecture in the chapter of interference. Okay. In the previous lecture we had studied about optical path difference, and also had introduced you to what is meant by phase of a wave. Okay. So in this lecture now we are going to discuss about phase difference. Okay. Well, phase difference, I had told you earlier, it is the difference in the phase of two or more waves. Two special cases of phase difference we are going to consider here now. What is meant by waves in phase, and then what is meant by waves out of phase. So, coming to the first part, waves, two or more waves are said to be in phase with respect to each other if the crest of one wave comes exactly over the crest of the other wave, and the trough of one wave comes exactly over the trough of the other wave. So as you can see in this figure here, the crest of this wave is coming exactly over the crest of the other wave, and the trough of the first wave is coming over the trough of the second wave. So they are exactly overlapping each other, crest over crest, trough over trough. So graphically, two waves are said to be in phase when crest comes over crest and trough comes over trough. Now, mathematically or in terms of phase difference, how do we define waves to be in phase? Now, to understand this phase, to find a phase difference, it's very simple. It is the phase of the wave 1 minus the phase of the wave 2, or phase of wave 2 minus the phase of wave 1, depending upon which phase is bigger. It's always bigger minus smaller. We want a positive answer, so it's always bigger minus smaller. So now, to find the phase difference of these two waves, wave 1 and wave 2, when they are in phase, we have to assign some phases to this point, starting point of this wave and starting point of this wave over here. Now how do we do that? To assign phases to these two waves, wave 1 and wave 2, let us refer to the diagram which we had seen in the previous lecture, that's about the phase of a wave. I had shown to you in this diagram. One full wave has a phase ranging from 0 to 2 pi, and then you can in between divide it by pi or pi by 2, and you can continue it in the wave. So as the wave progresses, remember a wave is not ending in one cycle, the wave continues in many cycles. So as the wave continues, so one wave is 0 to 2 pi, then the second wave is till 4 pi, then 6 pi and so on. So as the wave continues, we have increasing values of phase angles, delta, small delta. Now, if you compare this wave, the original wave, to the waves wave 1 and wave 2, what phases we can assign to this wave over here, at the starting point? What is happening in the wave 1 at the starting point? It is entering into a positive cycle. It's just entering into a positive cycle. So if you compare it with this reference wave which I have here, these points are starting into the positive cycle. You can see point 0 is starting into a positive cycle. The point 2 pi also is starting into a positive cycle. The point 4 pi, the point 6 pi, all these are starting into a positive cycle. So this point on the wave 1, I can write the phase of it as either 0 or 2 pi or 4 pi and so on, 6 pi and so on. Similarly for the wave 2, what phases can we assign at this point, starting point of this wave 2? The wave 2 also at this point, it is starting into a positive cycle. So the same thing what we have done for wave 1, 0, 2 pi, 4 pi, 6 pi, the same phases can also be assigned to the starting point of the wave 2. So the wave 2 also can have a phase of 0, 2 pi, 4 pi and so on. Okay, so now to find the phase difference, you have to find the difference in the phases of the two waves. So very simple, you have to take any one value of phase from the wave 1 and any one value of phase from the wave 2 and subtract them, bigger minus smaller. That will give you the phase difference delta. So let us see what values of possible phase difference we get when the waves are in phase. So suppose I take the value 0 from the wave 1 and the value 0 from the wave 2. If I subtract these two values, 0 minus 0 will give me an answer of 0. So this is one possible value of phase difference when waves are in phase. Another possible value, let us say we take the value from wave 1, we take the value 0 and from wave 2 we get the value 2 pi. Then 2 pi minus 0, the answer will be 2 pi. So this is another possible value of phase difference when waves are in phase. Another example, it says, let us say we take a value of 2 pi from the wave 1 and also 2 pi from the wave 2. 2 pi minus 2 pi will give you the answer 0, which is already listed out over here. Then, what are the other possible values? Suppose I take a value of 4 pi from the wave 1 and 0 from the wave 2. So 4 pi minus 0 will give you a value of 4 pi. So like this, if you take any values from here and any values from here and you subtract them, you will always get an answer of either 0 or 2 pi or 4 pi or 6 pi and so on in general. So in general we can say that it's an even multiple of pi. Okay, so waves to be in phase, the delta value must be an even multiple of pi. So mathematically we can write this as equal to 2n pi, where n can take values like 0, 1, 2 and so on, integral values. So if you see, for example, if you put the value of n here as 0, you will get the answer delta is equal to 0, which is the first value here. You put the value of n as 1, you will get the value of delta as 2 pi, which is the second value there. If you put the value of n as 2, you get the value of delta as 4 pi and so on. So this is the condition for waves to be in phase. The phase difference between them is an even multiple of pi. Please remember this, it's an important concept by heart. Okay? So waves are said to be in phase when the phase difference between them is an integral, is an even multiple of pi. Let's move to the second case now, waves out of phase. Okay, so you can see in this figure here, two waves are said to be out of phase with respect to each other when the crest of one wave comes over the trough of the other wave and the trough of the first wave comes over the crest of the second wave. So what is overlapping here is the crest is overlapping with the trough and trough overlapping with the crest. So in this way, graphically, we say that waves are out of phase when the crest of one wave overlaps the trough of the other wave and vice versa. So this is about out of phase. Now, similar way, the way we have done written equations, conditions for mathematical conditions for waves in phase, we are going to write similar conditions for waves out of phase. So for that, to find phase difference between wave 1 and wave 2, what we have to do is, we have to assign some phases for the starting point of the wave 1 and starting point of the wave 2, and then subtract the two values. That will give us the phase difference. So now, let's compare this wave 1 and wave 2 with the reference wave that I have here. And let's see what values I can assign to the starting point of wave 1 and the starting point of wave 2. If you see wave 1 at the starting point here, it is entering into a positive cycle. So if you compare with this reference wave over here, entering into a positive cycle happens at the point 0, 2 pi, 4 pi, 6 pi and so on. So at this starting point of the wave 1, I can assign values like 0 or 2 pi or 4 pi and so on, 6 pi and so on. What about wave 2? Wave 2 at the starting point here, it is entering into a negative cycle. So if you compare with this reference wave here, at which point is the wave entering into a negative cycle? The points are 3 pi, 5 pi and so on. At this point the wave is entering into a negative cycle. So what values I can assign to the wave 2 at the starting point here is either pi or 3 pi or 5 pi and so on. Now to find the phase difference between these two waves, I have to subtract the phase of wave 1 and the phase of wave 2, bigger minus smaller, so that we get a positive answer. So let us see what we get here. So possible values of delta, phase difference delta, for waves to be out of phase. So suppose from wave 1 I pick a value 0 and from wave 2 I pick a value pi. Pi minus 0 will give me an answer pi. So this is the first possible value of phase difference between two waves when the waves are out of phase. What are the possible values I can get? Suppose from the wave 1 I choose a value of 2 pi and from wave 2 I choose a value of pi. 2 pi minus pi again will give you an answer of pi which is already listed out here. What are the different values we get? So suppose from wave 1 I choose a value of 2 pi and from wave 2 I choose a value of 3 pi. 3 pi minus 2 pi again will give you a value of pi which is already listed out here. Next possible combination is, let us say from wave 1 I choose a value of 4 pi and from wave 2 I choose a value of pi. 4 pi from wave 1 and pi from wave 2. 4 pi minus pi will give you a value of 3 pi. So this is another value, possible value of waves to be out of phase. Phase difference when waves are out of phase. So like this, if you pick up any one value from here and any one value from here and subtract them, you will always get an answer either as pi or 3 pi or 5 pi and so on. Okay, so and so on. So this is the condition for waves to be out of phase. The phase difference between them is either pi or 3 pi or 5 pi or 7 pi. In general, it is an odd multiple of pi. Okay, so we can generalize this mathematically and write it as, for waves to be out of phase, the phase difference between them is an odd multiple of pi. So mathematically, how do we write an odd number? Odd number can be written as 2n plus 1 times pi. So odd multiple of pi. So for example, if I put, again, n over here takes the same values, integral values, 0, 1, 2, and so on. So for example, if I put n as 0 in this expression for delta, the bracket term will become 1, and so it will become 1 pi, which is pi, the first value. If I put n in this formula as 1, the term in the bracket will become 2 into 1 plus 1, which is 3, so 3 pi, the second value, and like that, 5 pi, 7 pi, you can generate values like that. So for waves to be out of phase, for waves to be out of phase, the phase difference between them, delta, must be an odd multiple of pi. So this is the condition which we need to remember for waves to be out of phase. So this slide is important part of this chapter. Rather, I will say this is the basics of this chapter, because based on this, further we are going to define what is meant by constructive interference and what is meant by destructive interference. It will be very simple henceforth. Constructive interference will happen when waves are in phase and destructive interference will happen when waves are out of phase. Okay, so we'll be dealing with that part in more details later on. So let's continue with phase and phase difference. So phase difference small delta and path difference which we had studied earlier, that's capital delta, are both related because they're both related to light. They are dealing with the same concept, same physical entity which is light. So they have to be somehow connected to each other. Small delta and capital delta, phase difference and path difference have to be connected to each other, and this is the formula which connects them. So delta is equal to small delta, phase difference is 2 pi by lambda times capital delta, where lambda is the wavelength of light. Okay, wavelength. So this is the relation which connects the phase difference to the path difference. For example, suppose I have a phase of pi. Suppose the phase difference of two waves is pi. What will be the corresponding path difference between them? You can calculate it by this formula. So in this formula, if you put delta as pi, what is the value of capital delta you will get? You can work out and see. In this formula, if you substitute delta as pi, you will get the value of capital delta as, so pi here, so it will be lambda by 2. You can check it out. The value of phase, path difference, capital delta, will be lambda by 2. So if you know the phase of any wave, using this relation, you can correspondingly get the path difference between the waves. Or conversely, if you know the path difference, you can get the value of phase difference. Now, we'll write down the same conditions which we have written for waves in phase and waves out of phase. But this time we write the conditions. In the previous slide we had written the condition in terms of phase. So for phase in phase, the condition was delta equal to 2n pi, and for out of phase, delta is equal to 2n plus 1 times pi. Now the same conditions we are going to write in terms of capital delta using the relation. So for in phase, for waves in phase, we already know that the value of small delta is 2n pi, and for waves out of phase we know that the condition for phase difference small delta is 2n plus 1 times pi. Now what are the corresponding values of delta, path difference between the two waves when they are in phase? So all you have to do is substitute this value of delta is equal to 2n pi into this formula, okay, into this formula, and you will get the corresponding value of capital delta. So you can work it out and see, you will get the value of delta by putting this value in that, the value of delta will come out to be as n lambda, okay. Again, so put the value of delta here as 2n pi, cancel out the terms which can cancel out, and you get the value of delta is path difference as n lambda. So where n can take values like 0, 1, 2 and so on, integral values. Similarly, for getting the values out of phase, corresponding value of delta in out of phase, again you have to substitute this value of delta here into this formula for small delta, and corresponding value of capital delta you can calculate. You can work it and see, you will get the value of capital delta as 2n plus 1 times lambda by 2. So such the value of delta as 2n plus 1 pi over here, and calculate the value of capital delta, you will get it as this value. So for waves out of phase, the path difference between them is 2n plus 1 times lambda by 2. In the forms of wordings, you can say that for waves in phase, the path difference delta between them is an integral multiple of lambda, and for waves out of phase, the path difference between them is an odd multiple of half wavelength. N plus 1 is an odd number, so odd multiple of half wavelength. So this is how we phrase our sentences while defining what are the conditions for waves in phase and the waves out of phase. Okay, so with this, we are going to stop over here in this lecture, and I hope you have understood this, because these are basic formulas. Please, I had these two formulas in phase, in terms of phase and path difference, and these two formulas in terms of phase and path difference for waves out of phase. So we are going to work on these formulas later on when we discuss about constructive and destructive interference. Okay, so thank you. We'll be continuing about the interference based on division of amplitude thin films in the next class. Thank you.